Hi there, I am making this video with a very heavy heart. Dear students, I lost my mother last week. I posted in community that how situation has changed and became grave and how she died of COVID-19. It is a very difficult time for me. It's a very grave and serious time for me. Actually, my whole family, my wife, my father, and I are suffering from this COVID-19. We tested positive, but still we are positive. And dear students, here I thought that I should communicate with you. I should have some words with you so that I can relieve my stress, because last few days were very difficult for us, for my whole family. Better thing in this pandemic or in this situation for me or for our family is that my two sons are safe, and we sent them to their maternal uncle's home, so they are safe. This is a good sight for us. And in this video I want to give you some experiences, and with these experiences how you can improve yourself if you are suffering from such type of situation. It's a very dangerous kind of situation, dear students. And as you know that no one come to you in this situation, people keep distance and the same kind of things are happening with us. But there are my friends, my colleagues and neighbors who are very generous. They are helping us, they are giving us food and all the necessary materials which required for us. So dear students, the situation have became very grave in last few days in our country, as we all are familiar with. And this pandemic has rushed to the rural area. My father and mother, they used to live in a village which is 50 kilometers from here where I stay, and they lived there. But this corona or COVID-19 reached in the villages, deeper villages, and now many villages are affected by this pandemic, and my family became the victim of same kind of thing. Dear students, actually my mother was suffering from fever and body pain, but she did not tell us. She just did not want to disclose what is going there in the village, and she never informed me. Actually we were calling him every day. Generally we call them every day, and she was just informing us that they are safe, but it was not so. They were not safe. And one day I heard her voice in a very lower tone, and I understood there might be something wrong happened, and I asked directly. Then she said that a fever came, and she was suffering from cough, which is the obvious symptom of COVID-19. Then I rushed to the village. I take her from there, and direct we went to the doctor, and then CT scan we made, blood tests were there, and report was positive, and her score was 15. Though it was stated there in the report, it is a moderate, severe, moderate score in the CT scan, but it was a very dangerous score, 15. And then she hospitalized here. Actually we got everything. We got oxygen. Initially in first few days she doesn't require any oxygen or any mask or concentrator, but after 4 or 5 days she required oxygen. But here where I live, there is no scarcity of oxygen. We have oxygen, we have medical ailments, all kinds of medical ailments. We went to civil hospital, and we also got a bed So there is always we find that people are asking for beds and there is scarcity of beds, but we are very fortunate, or I consider myself very fortunate that I got everything here in my town. But the students, she could not survive with all these things. Actually, we admitted her on 20th, and she required oxygen on 24th, means after 4-5 days, and then her condition was deteriorating gradually, and she never came back with that condition. Initially, doctors advised that remdesivir is not necessary because her condition is good, and definitely her condition was very good. She ate well in those days, those first 4 days in the hospital. I was there. I remained there for 11 days in the hospital, sitting on her bed and giving her support. But she never had been in such hospital, surrounded by the machines, ventilators, biopacks and oxygen concentrators. And I think that she got fear of all these kind of things because she never had been in such type of hospital, or she never had seen this type of condition, and she got fear. But I was there for 11 days and I supported her a lot. I talked to her, she talked to me, and many times we thought that we will recover in few days. So that was the condition. Then she ate well all the days. She asked me for food and different items. I provided dry fruits and other kind of things. So the condition was right till 24th, but after 24th she had to shift from a general ward to the emergency ward, and I took him to the emergency ward where oxygen mask was installed on her face. So she required oxygen after 4-5 days. Then again after 2 days, and this remdesivir, you might have heard about this medicine or this injection, remdesivir. She injected with this remdesivir, 5 remdesivir doctors used for her, and but still response was nothing, and gradually condition deteriorated. And after these injections and medicines, most of the medicines were standard they used, because there were a doctor called Vale Rao, who was a very generous person, and I was acquainted with him already. So I consulted with him. I also consulted another doctor in the town, but nothing worked. So situation became very grave and serious. And on 28th, she required a ventilator. So ventilator also was available. It is provided, ventilator mask attached to her face, and she started breathing again. But again, situation gone out of hand. Everything was there, medicine and all the things. But this disease is very dangerous. I saw from very close how people are craving for breathing. Shortness of breath is the last symptom of this corona or COVID-19. I saw everything there. I saw many patients. But there were some astonishing things happened too. There was a woman and her score was 24 out of 25. 24 CT scan score. And she spent 22 or 23 days in the hospital, but she survived. She is fine, she is fantastic now. But my mother could not, whose score was only 15. So this kind of things happening in the hospital or around you, you can see there are many people who are survived despite of their score, despite of their infection, despite of their heaviness of breath, everything. So you need to have willpower. You should not fear. That is very important. Your mental strength is important in this pandemic, dear students. So that woman whose score was 24, she survived, and now she is fantastic. She is well. She is out of danger. But in our case, the situation was not so. Then she required ventilator. Ventilator was provided, but still the heaviness of breathing did not stop. It was continued. Doctors used medicine, steroids, many kind of things, injections. I checked her blood, tested her blood many times in the lab. According to that tests, doctors prescribed medicines. She took medicines, but situation not improved. So it is also based on your mental strength. So it was a very dangerous situation where I lived. I lived in the hospital for 11 days with her. But it was of no use. I could not get success. I could not survive her. So dear students, on 1st May at 8 a.m. I woke her up and asked her water. She said only a few drops of water she required, and I give her. Then after some time I checked the machine and found there is no graph on the machine. There is no SpO2 saturation, which is very important in case of COVID patients. So no saturation. There was a blank space on the screen. And just I was asking her, mother, mother, just I was shouting. I went to the nurse and asked, please see the situation. Doctors rushed, and just they took another machine, installed another machine, that screen, and trying to check. But meantime I understood she lived the world. That is a very, very grave situation. It was a very grave moment for me, but still I looked at her. She looked serene and calm, because she struggled a lot. She struggled to survive. Her fight was now over with the destiny. So that was a very, what I say to you, a very grim situation. Then the things happened. I took her body to my village. There we made her last funeral pyres and all the things. Then we came back to the town. First we rushed, my father, my wife and I, to the CT scan center. There I made CT scans of all members. We had CT scans and our score came 3 each. My score was 3, her was 3, and my father's was again 3. So we were infected. But when we did this RT-PCR and antigen tests, those were negative tests. RT-PCR were negative 2 times. We did these tests for 2 times, and 2 times, both the times, they were negative. And hence, we tried this CT scan. Then we had to take the treatment, and on 2nd May the treatment started. We took treatment from a doctor who was already working there in the COVID center in civil hospital, 5 days we took treatment that Pipzo and some antibiotics and steroids, the 5 days dose, and now we are improving. Still test, I lost the taste and smell. Still there is no taste on my tongue, and weakness is there in the body. So I asked to the doctor and he said this will remain for a month. Now it has been said that it is a very dangerous and grave disease, but if you have strength, if you have willpower, it is nothing. So first I would like to inform you, you should not stay at home if you require hospitalization. It is very important, and you should be very careful about your health, about your monitoring of body, because many times we see that there are people who do not have any symptom, they are asymptomatic people, and these people are very dangerous to others because they are spreading this disease, COVID-19. So you should be careful. You should all the time wear mask whenever you go out of your home, whenever you go in the market. You should use sanitization very properly. Sanitize your hands, sanitize your clothes, sanitize whatever you are exposed to. It is very important. And monitor your body temperature, monitor your SpO2, monitor your oxygen levels in your family. Take care of you and your family too. If you have fever, there are many symptoms of COVID-19. And rural area, people are saying that it is typhoid, because the symptoms of typhoid and this COVID-19 are similar. They are same, and hence they are getting confused with this typhoid. And many doctors there are in rural areas, doctors who are directly started treating people with typhoid medicines, which was not true. The same case has happened with my mother. A doctor prescribed her the medicines of typhoid. When I consulted here to a doctor, he said that her withdrawal test is negative, no typhoid. So this kind of things are happening. So you should be aware about this kind of things happening in the rural area. So first, there are many symptoms: body pain, diarrhea, loss of taste, loss of smell, then fever. Fever is obvious a symptom, headache. So these symptoms are of COVID-19 symptoms. So you should be careful about these symptoms. So keep watch on your health and your family members' health. It is very important. Whenever you think that you are suffering from some kind of fever or some kind of this symptom, please consult to your doctor, go to your doctor. And let me tell you that the treatment of this COVID-19 is not a very high kind of treatment or high profile or high medicine. This is not so. It's a very simple treatment. If you go to doctor, just he will give you steroids or some kind of antibiotics and you will be safe. But it should be in the initial stage. If you are staying at home, it is dangerous without taking medicines. If you are staying at home with medicines or medications, it's all right, no problem. But you should take medicine. You should be very careful about all these things, monitoring your systems. So this is what, dear students, I wanted to share with you, because I was feeling very stressful, and many days passed now and we are improving, my wife, my father and I. We are improving. We have completed all doses. So this is a bright side of our improvement. So I thought I should share this information with you. So dear students, we will start our regular videos in some coming days. Once I improve myself, once I feel confident, then I will come to you. I will come before you. So thank you very much for watching. If you have any doubt, any kind of thing, you can ask me. Thanks. Let's meet in the next video.